Good morning, ladies and gentlemen. My name is Akash Chaudhary. So my presentation today is about the VLDM. It's all about performing simulations in supply chain flow. So about the GRAIN, it's developed at MIT in 1960 for training purposes. The game helps to experience the supply chain concepts, the collaboration and the teamwork across different entities, the bullwhip effect, and it also explains the importance in the fluctuation in the demands, the lead times, customer demand, and the cost. So the game represents four roles: the retailer, wholesaler, distributor, and manufacturer. Depending upon the consumer's demand, the retailer plays to the wholesaler, wholesaler plays to the distributor, and distributor plays the order to the manufacturer, and the supply will happen vice versa. So in this game, by default, I repeat again, by default, the game starts with a stock of 12 units and a demand of 4 units each for the next 2 weeks. And the total lead time between each stages is 3 weeks, that is 1 week to order and 2 weeks for the delivery. So we have played our game. So as a retailer, it was by the computer, wholesaler by me, distributed by Santosh, and manufactured by Akhil. So overall, our own gaming review. So we participated typically to crack the whip. The game started with a steady demand, and increased demand was generated, and this induced variation in supply flow. Participated, tried to compensate, and errors and the amplifications are rectified. So, description of my role: a wholesaler. What is a wholesaler? A wholesaler may be an individual or a company that buys product in bulk from an authorized distributor of specific product manufacturer and supplies that product to different retailers upon receiving the confirmation. So this is our combined result, and we used Eagle strategy, and by using Eagle strategy we have achieved some good results comparing to the lean strategy. So here we got $1924 as total stock, stock cost and back order, including back order cost, and 54 units. And this is our combined result while performing lean strategy. So the figures are quite higher in this using lean strategy. This is our comparison. So here I am proceeding my analysis with the lean strategic game for describing my individual supply chain role. So as I said, I am following now the Agile strategic game. So this is our combined fill rate. A fill rate is a fraction of customer demand that is met through immediate stock availability without any back orders. So as I said, I am explaining my individual supply chain role. I am playing as a wholesaler, and I have achieved 91% in following Eagle strategic game. Now comes to the bullwhip effect. What is bullwhip effect? It's nothing but amplifications or the variations in demand, the flow, the variations in the demand while proceeding to the supply chain flow. You can see that here there is steady demand, and if the demand increases without any pre-alerts, our supply chain flow suddenly increases, and this amplification should be controlled. And this amplification, which is also called bullwhip effect, it should be controlled till the end. Factors contributing to the bullwhip effect: lead, impact time on supply chain, impact of batch ordering, magnifying effects of inflated orders, demand forecasting inaccuracy, information and decision, and decision isolation. These are the factors. So describing about my role and my game while I played as a wholesaler. Initially the game started smoothly with a constant demand. Stocks were being maintained physically according to the demand, and has a reason. Cost was also very low. This yellow color represents the cost, and it was very low initially. But from week 15 onwards, there is a sudden rise in the demand from the retailer, and due to the low stock availability, the back orders, the red ones are the back orders, and you can see the back orders are rising from week 15. So to overcome the back orders, we have started maintaining the stock level. The blue ones are stock level, and once we reached the week 30th, the back orders were controlled due to the highly placing of the stocks. And if we keep maintaining the stocks, obviously the stock, the cost will also be increased, but we have to see that it is in our control. So by the end of the 52nd week, everything was under control and everything was back into our game. Our stocks, our demand was steady, our stock maintaining was also low, and we maintained quite feasible inventory holding cost. Supply chain strategy. So what I have observed that it's a demand driven planning strategy to mitigate the bullwhip effect. So how to mitigate the bullwhip? We must adopt a business operating model based on a real-time demand, where we can shape our networks and we can grasp the demand, reducing uncertainties and providing centralized information about the demand. Here we don't know about the demand. What we don't know about the demand patterns. We don't know when consumer will buy the right amount of products. So without knowing these things, the maintaining the supply flow is really very hectic. So we have to plan something, and in this 2020s generation, technology, we have to take some help of technologies to overcome these kind of situations. And reducing lead times, increasing the mode responsiveness, reducing variability and promoting volume spikes along with reliable deliveries, collaborating with supply chain entities and sharing the information across the supply chain. Sharing, collaborating in the terms of our information, as a retailer, his information should be shared with the distributor. Distributor's information should be shared with the retail, with the manufacturer, and it should form like a cloud. So introducing a supply chain cloud in 2020 generation for a better supply chain visualization. You can see this is a cloud computing environment where we can store our data, and those data can be seen by a supplier, by a manufacturer, by a retailer, by a warehouse or a distributor. And using this data, we can predict the demand. We can plan our stock levels. We can see the logistic cost, and everything we can get information using this cloud computing. And from this point of view, every supply chain entity or every player in the business can be benefited. So this is all about improving the logistic drop cost, slashes the inventory cost, lowering the working capital requirements, and improving the asset utilizations. These are some of my references to finish the presentation. Thank you.